So which is going to be the best camera lens protector between the Spigen Glaster Slim, the RhinoShield 9H Tempered Glass Protector, the Zag Glass Fusion, the Rinky Camera Styling Screen Protector, and the Shelver Sapphire Lens Protector? It's going to be the Shelver Sapphire Lens Protector because it actually protects your camera lenses. Everything else is basically the equivalent of trying to stay dry during a downpour by wearing an extra cotton t-shirt. For the rest of this comparison video, I'm going to talk about the pros and the cons for each product. If there is one product that you're more interested in, use the chapters in the video timeline to jump to that product. I've done full reviews for each one of these products, so those links will be in the cards as I'm talking about them or in the description section below. Except for this thing, but I'm not going to do a full review on it because it's terrible. At Mobile Reviews, Amonte and I base our reviews on actual usage. We started reviewing these camera lens protectors about 2 months ago, kind of middle of May. It's kind of the middle of July now. So it's taken us about 2 months to get to this point where we could do a big full roundup about them. Reviewer, not influencer. In the process of doing all these reviews, Monty's learned two things that he thinks you guys need to know about camera lens protectors. The first thing is that these protectors aren't as protective as they sound. The only thing they might do is prevent your camera lens from breaking. Maybe. And I say maybe because out of the dozens and dozens of iPhones I've dropped over the last few years, I've yet to break an actual camera lens. But through this entire review promise, almost every other drop that I've done the last while with a camera lens protector on the iPhone has resulted in that protector cracking. Now, if you're worried about scratch protection, the camera lens themselves are very scratch resistant. Glass companies love to bedazzle you with marketing fluff and plaster their products with stuff like 9H hardness, super strong, tempered. But here's the thing, there's actually two 9Hs. There's one on the graphite scale and the one on the Mohs scale. And they're not the same thing. 9H on the graphite scale is about 6-7 on the Mohs scale. And the coolest thing is that the iPhone's camera lenses themselves have a hardness between 8-9 on the Mohs scale, according to my scratch test. So out of the five products that you are seeing here Monty, you can have this one. Four of them will actually be more scratch prone to the glass it's trying to protect. Now, the second thing that Monty wants you to know is that basically using one of these products, you're gonna sacrifice the photo quality. Four out of the five products in this video will introduce artifacts into your photos. You'll get ghosting and glare issues, and the only product that offers the best photo quality, it's gonna be the Rinky Camera Fusion thing. Why? Because it actually doesn't cover the camera. It's a great protector. And the reason for this is that most of these products actually don't have a layer of adhesive between the glass protector and the actual camera lens. So between those two panes of glass, light's just doing this when you're taking photographs. It's just bouncing between the two. Now, I will admit that I generally lean towards the more satirical, negative aspects of products. So I really try hard to think about good things about all these products. And well, I'll touch on that in the end because you just want to see the pros and cons. So let's start with the products that you should stay away from, which is this one, the Zag Fusion Glass. When it comes to pros, this is the only product that won't change the look of your iPhone's camera area. What other good things can I say about this product? Did I miss anything? When it comes to cons, these glass fusion protectors will scratch between 2-3 on the Mohs scale, which is a far cry from the 8-9 found on the iPhone camera lenses. But the marketing fluff makes it look like it's very, very scratch protective. Another con is that you can easily take your finger and move the protectors around, and if you do that, taking photos with those movable protectors is, well, not great. Next up is the Rinky camera styling, but on the back it says screen protector, so I don't really know. When it comes to cons, this is the only product that really changes the way your camera area looks. Instead of nice frosted glass or just glass, you can slap on a piece of metal. But be warned, it doesn't take much to it off. The fit of this product, from my perspective, is, I'll say, better than the Spigen one because it has a chamfered edge. So using this with an ultra-thin case or by itself is gonna be fine. You're not gonna notice the edge of the product much. When it comes to not great things, this is it's not gonna offer any protection for the actual camera lenses. There's something to be said about adding a tiny little lip to the camera lens, but that's a moot point if you're using a case. And the cutout around the flash is gonna reduce the effectiveness of the flash along the edges of your photographs. But it's on the side, so it doesn't really matter, but it still happens. Now, if you're planning on getting a lens protector, make sure you use my links, as some of these companies have given me discount codes for them. So yeah, check the description or the pinned comment and you can find if they're still active or not, because some of them are not. These guys, I think, put a time limit on them. Next up is the Spigen Glaster Slim. And if you are completely paranoid about shattering your camera lens, this product would probably be the one that I would recommend. There's two two protectors in each package, which is kind of handy because you can kind of dwell in that false sense of security that this product actually did something. It broke, so it must have protected the camera, right? When it comes to cons, the edges of this product are very noticeable. Unlike the Rinky product where the adhesive is applied straight to the metal piece, Spigen has a piece of foam between the adhesive and the glass. This is most likely there to provide the protector with a bit of give so it doesn't crack from a sneeze. Now, like the Rinky product, your camera flash will be reduced and your photos will take on, you know, weird things like ghosting and glare issues. I can't stress this enough, it only happens when you're shooting directly into a light source. So, you know, just normal photographs of like Monty, photographs will not be affected in any way, I don't think. From what I've seen anyways. And this goes for all the products. The glass that Spigen uses in their Glass for Sim product scratches at a soft 6. So again, the product is gonna scratch much quicker than the camera lens itself. Next up is the Reinold Shield Tempered Glass 9H Lens Protector. And this is a pretty good product. If you really want to change the look of your iPhone, the camera lens, you could get one of these because the anodized aluminum rings that go around each piece of glass is like in your face. The individual protectors also eliminate the loss of flash that you would get from the Spigen Rinky products. Now, pseudo pro for this product, and yes, I said pseudo, is that it will offer better scratch protection than the Spigen one. It scratches at a, I'm gonna say a hard 7, soft 8. And that was actually kind of surprising because most tempered glass scratches between 6 and 7. Now, the pseudo con is that it's still not as strong as the glass on the actual iPhone camera lens. So still run into that problem where the thing that you're protecting, you're not actually as strong as the thing you're protecting. So the last thing I don't like about the Reinold Shield product is that the things come off quite easily. Val lost every one of her protectors on our first pass with this product. Now I initially thought that was caused by the sharp edges along the protector, but there is a slight chamfering. So it's not gonna catch on much, which just means the adhesive on this product needs to be stronger. Nothing like spending $5 per little tiny glass and having to go just randomly. Like, I think Val found one out of the three that she lost, and it was just like in her living room in the carpet. The last product, and the only product that you should maybe seriously consider, is the Shailrus Sapphire lens protector, which is this thing. The Shailrus product is the only one that will add more protection than the default protection found on your iPhone camera lenses. My Mohs 9-Pick does nothing to this product, whereas the 9-Pick will leave tiny scratches on an iPhone 11's camera lenses. I've done that lots of times, and it's just really so cool to see. But here's the thing when it comes to the scratch test, is that I can lightly scratch it and with the 9-Pick, and it will scratch all of these products, and it will not leave a mark on the iPhone lens. But if I really crank it and put all my might into it, I will definitely scratch up that camera lens. And there's something to be said about that, because the harder I press something, the more likely it's going to scratch. Now, the adhesive on the Shailrus protectors is quite aggressive, as we didn't actually lose any during our testing period. And from a physical standpoint, they aren't as noticeable because there's actually more glass than an aluminum when compared to the Reinold Shield product. The only con I have with this product is that the light artifacts are very apparent when dealing with certain photo shots against direct light sources. I did mention this to Shailrus, and they were looking into adding a layer of anti-reflective coating onto the inside of the protector. That will probably do something, but again, if you are concerned with absolute protection for your product, this is the one to get out of all the ones here, from my perspective. Now, the only good thing that I kind of came across when doing all these products for camera lens protectors, and I still think they're a little silly, is that they allow you to change the look of your iPhone. And I didn't realize how much I enjoyed doing that until I took the gold rings from Shailrus, or from Reinold Shield, and stuck them on my midnight green iPhone 11 Pro Max with my gold ringed Casetify monogram case. And that thing just looks so narcissistic, doesn't it? Like, come on guys, that just looks awesome. Again, if you are planning on buying one of these products, I do think I have codes for these two, for the Shailrus and the Reinold Shield ones. Spigen doesn't give me any codes. It's funny, the prices on their Amazon store is generally cheaper than going directly through their store, so make sure you use the Amazon links for the Spigen stuff. The Rinky, glasses and Zag, don't touch that. That's a bad product. First time watching one of my videos, I do encourage you to click subscribe. Producing content, we're gonna say once or twice a week, maybe more. Haven't figured that part out because we just finished the isolation video series, which was 120 videos in 115 days. So I'm just still kind of recovering from that a little bit. Anyways, that's all I got. Thanks for watching. Circle. You gotta turn around, we're not done.
We're not done. Circle. No. Circle. Circle.
Now, if you're planning on getting